Hey there, scientists. Caroline here. Hold on. Huh. I just got an air quality alert. It looks like the air isn't great today. Might be best to stay indoors. Have you ever received one of these alerts on your phone? Or maybe you've seen air quality mentioned in a weather report but weren't sure what it meant. In the US, air quality is reported daily, and you can find it on most weather apps or your local news. But what exactly does it mean when you see an air quality alert? And what even is air quality anyway? Today, we'll be investigating these questions and more as we explore one of our most valuable resources, the air we breathe. Ready, scientists? Let's get started. Simply put, air quality tells us how clean or polluted the air around us is, and how safe it is to breathe. Scientists measure air quality using a tool called the Air Quality Index, or AQI for short. It's the same index used in the air quality alert I just received. The AQI ranges from 0 to 500. The lower the number, the cleaner the air. Higher numbers mean increasing levels of pollution that can be harmful to both human health and the environment. To make it easier to understand, the AQI scale is color-coded. Green means good, yellow is moderate, orange is unhealthy for sensitive groups, red is unhealthy for everyone, purple is very unhealthy, and maroon means the air is hazardous. But why might AQI change based on location or time? Let's look at some factors that influence air quality. Scientists, I want you to picture a place with the freshest air you can imagine. Close your eyes, visualize it, and take a deep breath. What location did you think of? Pause and record the location in your guided notes. Me? I pictured scenic mountains surrounded by an evergreen forest. Maybe you thought of something similar, or perhaps you imagined the countryside, wide open fields with a gentle breeze. This connection between clean air and nature isn't just in our imagination. It highlights an important factor affecting air quality: green spaces, or areas with more trees, parks, and vegetation. Green spaces tend to improve air quality because plants absorb pollutants and release oxygen. But when trees are cut down and replaced with paved surfaces, fewer green spaces remain to trap heat and pollution, which can make air quality worse. Human activity, especially in developed areas, tends to reduce air quality. If you live in or near a big city with lots of cars, factories, and people, chances are the AQI is affected by all that activity. More traffic, industrial emissions, and energy use mean more pollution, leading to lower air quality. I do live near a big city, but here's the thing. I also live near several parks, and the AQI isn't usually this high. So maybe something else is causing today's air quality alert. This brings us to another key factor: geography and climate. The natural landscape plays a big role in air quality. For example, mountains can trap pollution in valleys, making it harder for air pollution to clear out. Climate matters too. Warm, sunny regions tend to have more smog, which commonly forms when sunlight reacts with pollutants. Natural events like wildfires and dust storms can also cause sudden spikes in pollution, decreasing air quality. All right, scientists. We've explored some factors that affect air quality, but why does it matter? Before we get into it, scientists, what do you think are some impacts of poor air quality on human health or the environment? Pause and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Poor air quality doesn't just make the air look hazy, it also has an effect on our health. In the short term, breathing polluted air can irritate airways, making it harder to breathe. This can be dangerous for people with respiratory conditions like asthma, as pollution can trigger symptoms or make them worse. This is why you'll sometimes hear air quality alerts urging people, especially young children, older adults, and those with health conditions, to limit outdoor activities. And these short-term risks can add up over time. Long-term exposure has been linked to heart disease, lung disease, and certain types of cancer. Now, to be clear, this doesn't mean that breathing polluted air one time, or even many times, is going to cause an illness in the future. But it does mean that too much exposure to air pollution over a long enough time can increase the risk for certain types of disease. And the impacts don't stop with us. Scientists, how do you think low air quality affects ecosystems as a whole? Low air quality can harm ecosystems in a variety of ways. For example, it can damage plants by interfering with photosynthesis, leading to food shortages for other organisms. Or when pollutants in the air settle into bodies of water, they can make lakes and rivers more acidic, harming fish and other aquatic life. This in turn can affect other living things that depend on aquatic life. Every part of the environment is interconnected. That's why monitoring air quality is so important. It's not just about us. It's about making sure that all living things have access to clean air. The good news? Humans have come a long way in the past 100 years in better understanding air quality and its impacts. And we've made some meaningful changes, which we'll discuss more in a future lesson. And with that, we've wrapped up our intro lesson on air quality. We've learned that the Air Quality Index is a tool that helps us understand how clean, or polluted, the air is. There are a variety of factors that affect air pollution, such as green spaces, human activity, geography, and climate. Air quality can impact the health of humans and ecosystems, which is why monitoring air quality matters. It helps us understand both environmental and health impacts so we can make informed choices about air quality moving forward. In our next lesson, we'll investigate different kinds of pollution to determine what's causing the air quality alert in my area. Until then, I'm Caroline, and remember, the air we breathe is a resource we all share. Every choice we make can help keep it clean, so don't underestimate the impact you can have. Stay observant, keep asking questions, and I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.